Dear students, today we will discuss about the last cycle, that is testing phase. So we have covered all of these phases: requirement, design and implementation. So now we want to focus on testing. So actually the testing is one of the most important phase of software development. So whatever has been built using the implementation, and whatever has been designed using the design, and whatever the requirements have been gathered using the requirement analysis phase and have been documented in the software requirement specification document. So testing need to check all of such things and need to identify that all of the requirements have been met and there are not any bugs, there are no errors in the software. So softwares need to be properly verified so that afterwards the software is not having any issues when deployed to the users. So we have discussed some software verification examples in the previous modules when the systems were not actually properly tested, and those have even taken the life of some of the people when the radiation was given more based on the failure of the software. So testing is one of the most important phase. So traditionally in the testing, the testing community was only focusing on debugging, so identifying the bugs and just seeing that confirming the software is compatible to software requirement specification document or not. So that's it. So this was only the testing involved in the traditional software testing phase. However, in modern testing, so the programs are not the only artifacts that are tested during the software development process. Indeed, the result of each intermediate step need to be checked. So I will give here one example. So for example, if your system need to produce the output of 4 against two values which are 2 and 2. So these two are 2 are the two inputs of your program, and it need to produce output of 4. So one of the strategy could be to just check that, to just give the input 2 and your program has produced the value of 4. Actually, on the backend side here we have used the multiplication symbol, but the actual requirement was the plus symbol. So whether you use plus or multiplication, you will get the answer 4 as it is. So this means if you do not go inside the code to check that whether you have actually implemented the software with proper limitations or proper constraints and proper methodology and the requirement, then you are not able to say that your software is properly verified. So such a testing which goes inside into the code to see that whether each part of the code is properly implemented and all intermediate steps are properly working. So such kind of methodology in software engineering which checks the code is known as white box testing. And black box testing is another methodology which only checks what are the inputs and what the software has to achieve and what the software has achieved. So in black box testing, this phenomena of plus and static will not be or cannot be identified. It need to be, the code need to be checked in this scenario. So modern testing, testing should not be considered as separate step. They are also saying that you should test for each and every step. So requirement analysis phase should be termed as requirement analysis and confirmation. So this confirmation is basically the testing of the software requirement analysis phase. And then they are saying that you should not say there is a design phase. You should rather say design and validation. So all design need to be validated. So whatever the design has been proposed, it need to be validated by using different techniques. So whether the design is proper or it has some issues before even the implementation. And then they are saying that the next phase should be implementation and testing. So still, as we have discussed, that there are still many problems which we see, that software crashes at different places and large software system continue to contain errors even after significant testing, and many of these errors may go undetected for the life of the systems. So it has also been identified that a software was being executed since the last more than 10 years and there was a bug and error that was not detected, and that was detected after 10 years. And others may cause major malfunction, as we discussed, that they can take even the life of the persons. So this means that whatever strategies we have adopted to test the softwares properly, they need more research, they need more challenges to be solved in software engineering, so that we can claim someday that we have actually tested this software and this software will not crash or will not have any errors. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned about testing, the traditional testing, and what are being focused in the modern testing, and